Okay, this is getting out of hands. You mean to tell me that this is not a real person? This is not a real person. This is not a real person. I thought DALL-E was really good, but this new AI is giving me the chills. Don't get me wrong, DALL-E is really good, but I've not seen anything as realistic as Lexica. This is more than 3D rendering. When it comes to landscape shots, it's difficult to tell the difference between this and a real image. And when it comes to images of people, I've never been so wild. I thought ChatGPT was mind-blowing, but these are some of my creations with Lexica. Some of them are really hilarious, but look at this. Look at this. I described a horse close to a waterfall with the moon, and we have this. When it comes to describing the faces of people and saying, hey, can you give me this person that does this thing? So this is another generation I did of a person with a laptop with an elephant, and we have this right here. So I described an African woman with a laptop, and you mean to tell me that this person is not real? I don't believe it. I didn't believe that this was not a real image. And I went to Google and decided to do an image search. So let's try this out with some of the images that we have so far. I want to really be sure that these are not real people, that this AI is not just giving me images of people from the internet. And apparently this person does not exist. Like, this AI just created this person from scratch. This very realistic image from scratch. So I'll show you the prompt I used to create this. I describe this person and the person in the background, and we have this. So this person does not exist, and this person, it's difficult to believe that this person does not exist. So let's go with the face. This person does not exist. How is this possible? You know, if it was 10 years ago or 20 years ago, when people were saying, hey, AI might take over the world, AI might end up controlling humans, AI might end up doing so many bad things or so many awesome things, a lot of people were like, okay, these are just conspiracy theories. But you saw what we've seen with DALL-E so far, what we've seen with ChatGPT, and what we're seeing with Lexica, where we can have images of people as real as this, that is difficult to tell between this and an actual image, that this looks realer than real images. And we're going to try a couple of this out. I also used DALL-E with the same prompts to generate an image of a person, and we got this, which is still really cool. This is what I got with DALL-E. And the prompt right here, HD shot of a beautiful black female model looking at the camera in a fashion show, straight and well-defined nose, full lips, long thick. So I described the face, and we got this with DALL-E, and we got this with Lexica. Now, both of them are cool, but if someone told me, hey, I generated this with DALL-E, I'll be like, okay, that makes sense. I mean, this seemed like AI generated in a way. I mean, if you're told, maybe at first glance, you wouldn't think that, okay, this was AI generated. But then if you're told, you're like, you can agree that this is AI generated. But this one, do you agree that this is AI generated? We've gotten to the age of image generation that it's difficult to tell between real and fake anymore. This is also generated from scratch with DALL-E. So some people misunderstand this AI, image generators. They think that the AI goes to the internet and takes images that already exist and just feeds them back to people. But no, these images don't exist. The AI has already been fed with a lot of data set of what elephants look like, of what human beings look like, black people, tall people, describe the faces. Thousands and thousands, or maybe even millions of images of what people look like. And you say, hey, draw me an elephant. It knows what an elephant looks like, and it starts drawing an elephant with every description you can give it, and it comes up with a new unique image. So this is how DALL-E works. This is how stable diffusion works. This is how AI like Lexica works. And I really love this image of elephants, and I also added the moon to the picture, and then we have elephants in wildlife. You can see the trees, you can see those at the back. So this is from scratch. You know that this is not just copied and pasted from the internet. You can see some things like this, where we have the what's this called for an elephant? We have this, you can just see this in the image. So this is the AI generating this image from scratch. And it's pretty amazing what we have here with both DALL-E and Lexica. This is another one I did with DALL-E of elephants looking at the moon, and you can see two elephants looking at the moon right here. So what I want to do right now is try out some images I've generated with DALL-E. These are really, really creative, good looking images I've generated with DALL-E. I want to take those same prompts and try them out in Lexica. So right here, this is a photograph of an astronaut riding a horse, stars, moon, cinematic lighting. And one thing I've noticed as a difference between Lexica and DALL-E is that DALL-E uses kind of the technology behind ChatGPT also in understanding description, saying this person has to be on top of this person or this thing has to be doing this thing. But Lexica might not get the full context at times. But if you provide it with a good detailed description and make sure you include the keywords, it understands. So this is a photograph of an astronaut riding a horse. Wow. This is DALL-E and this is Lexica. Both images look really good, but it feels like a shot taken with an HD camera, and that's amazing. It's really amazing what this AI can do. Here's another one I did of two mice in Hawaii. I've tried this out with Stable Diffusion, and Stable Diffusion gives me the most hilarious image generation when it comes to things like this particular description, for example. So let me go try it out with Lexica and see. So a macro 35mm photograph of two mice in Hawaii. They're each wearing tiny swimsuits and are carrying tiny softballs digital art. So let's see what this is gonna look like. So look at that. We have two mice and they're not wearing anything. So these are realistic images. This looked like it was actually taken with the camera. But then in terms of context, DALL-E wins, because DALL-E gets the context. Hey, two mice in Hawaii. Oh, DALL-E know that this has got to look like Hawaii. They're each wearing tiny swimsuits, and we have something like this, tiny swimsuits. But with Lexica gives us that realistic shot, but then in terms of context, we're not really getting much of the context there. So we just have two mice, they're not wearing any swimsuit, and the softboard is not that visible. But then again, these are images of mice that look like real shots taken with your phone or with your camera, which is really amazing. Let's try a last one. Let me say a man sitting by a river fishing, and maybe there's a lion beside him, and just gonna write mod and see what this AI is gonna give us to generate. So first of all, we have this one. This looks really clean, but it doesn't look like that shot that's taken from the car. It looks really beautiful, by the way. It doesn't look like that shot that's taken from a camera, or maybe it looks like a camera shot but heavily edited. Either ways, it looks really good. So we have the lion in the mud. The lion's skin feels like cloth, but the lion's in the mud right there, and this is the man fishing. I don't know what this is supposed to look like. And let's see the second image. Okay, so we have the lion right here. This looks like a real shot. Now we have the man right here, and this is another place that AI really messes up. AI image generations find a really hard time drawing the hands, so the fingers are very, very difficult for AI to draw. But you see the same thing with DALL-E, Stable Diffusion. You see the same thing with Mid Journey. So Mid Journey is another AI image generator, although Mid Journey is the one I found that does it the best. But all of them are really terrible at generating hand images. So this is another one, and yeah, so these ones look kind of realistic. This is the lion. The lion doesn't look all that realistic. So, but we have the man right here fishing, and you can tell that this is image generated because of the leg. What if we try maybe a studio shot of a handsome man, and let's say cinematic lighting, looking at the camera, and colored lighting also. Let's see what we have. So let's generate this, and I really want to see what we get from a vague description. So we just have a studio shot of a handsome man, but we did not really describe the man. We did more description of the background than the person itself. So all it has is a handsome man. Are these people really not real? If I come to Google Lens and I try this. Now, not only are they not real, are you saying it doesn't look like anyone at all? It brings nothing. This is it for Lexica. You should try Lexica and see what you can create with this. I really enjoyed this the most. I enjoyed this the most because I made the description of the people here more detailed. AG shot of a beautiful black female model looking at the camera in a fashion show. So that should be the same thing with what we have here. So straight and well-defined nose, full lips, long thick eyelashes, almond shade eyes, deep, you know, and all of this we're able to get these really beautiful looking realistic shots of people that don't exist. It's still mind-blowing that this is the case. What do you think the future of image generation is going to be? The future of images in general, because the direction we're going right now, the direction we are right now, nothing is real anymore. You can create different images of different people doing different things. You can create images of people that don't exist. You can create images of people that do exist, doing things that they've never done before. So we're not going to be able to get proof that, hey, this is an image of this person doing this, or this is a video of this person doing this, because right now, not even text is real anymore, not images are real anymore, videos are becoming really not real anymore, and I don't know where we're going with digital creations anymore. So let me know what you think in the comment section and give this a shot. Send me a photo or a link to whatever it is you are able to create with this image generator. So see you in my next video, which you can go check out right now. Check this one out right now.